So when I first saw the Apple Vision Pro, the first thing that came to mind to me, is this something I'm actually going to use? Like, as a normal person that works throughout the week, is the Apple Vision Pro going to be something that I'm going to want to take with me when I'm on the go? Is it something that can actually be part of my productive lifestyle? Now, I've seen many people say that, yes, I think these would be really awesome when we jump on airplanes and have that, you know, spatial computing, but yet have some privacy on what it is that you're doing. But today, what I'm going to show you guys is how, as someone that's in the photography business and reports to the news, I constantly have to do photography editing in real time. So what does it mean for me to go to a 13-inch, 14-inch laptop to having a virtual space, a studio, where I can go ahead and edit my photos and get the items done that I need to do on a much bigger canvas? That, to me, is what intrigues me about the Vision Pro, and that's what we're going to do today. We're going to look at this as, is this something that, for someone that is in the photography business, that uses Lightroom, is this something that they can really utilize? Is the quality there? Is it something I can spend a half hour to an hour editing photos? And can I create a workflow that makes sense and not an inconvenience while giving myself a better end product? So let's go through the pros and cons. All right, so you can see right here is my canvas. Right now it's totally blank. So the first thing we're going to do, we're going to go up here and we are going to select our control panel and we're going to check our Vision Pro and select our MacBook Pro. Now you can see my screen laptop is here and now it is here. We're going to move this over just a little bit just so we can benefit from this a little bit so you guys can see that that's the camera. So we're going to go ahead and now I can utilize my keyboard. And I was really impressed that I actually can look down and see my keys, because sometimes I need that. And my mouse is responsive. So this is my canvas. A couple things I want you to be able to know is I can go ahead and I can click and hold here, and I can move my virtual display however I want. I can go ahead and I can pull it in and get it real close. I can also put it back in distance. When I push it way back, the transparency kind of changes. We're going to bring it right about there. I can bring my eyes over here, and this allows me to zoom in and zoom out, so I can really customize the screen however I want. Now, I'm gonna come back here. I'm just gonna put this over top of my MacBook, just so you guys can kind of see what that screen looks like. And it kind of looks like that, roughly the same size. So I can bring that up here, and now you can see that screen as that space. Well, again, we can click and hold and bring that way out here. And that gives us a really big canvas to work with. Now, I can also go ahead and I can bring in other apps into the picture. So let's just say, for example, I want to bring in my photo library. I can do that and it's going to pull my photo library here. And I could also station that right here. If I wanted to go ahead and bring in my email, I could do that. And I could bring my email in, which is over here right now, and we can move that to maybe over here. And then while I'm at it, just for the sake of it, I'm gonna bring in my browser. And this is really big if I'm gonna be importing or taking videos or photos and pushing them to the web. So in this case, I'm putting in Facebook, and I'm just gonna move this for the moment, maybe right over here. So we can see that. So right there is my Facebook page, and you can see collections of photos in there. If you want to follow me on Facebook and check out what we're doing there, go ahead and do so. But let's talk about utilizing Lightroom. Now I have my canvas set up here. I'm going to go ahead and open up Lightroom Classic. As I mentioned, I'm often on the go, having to go to various shoots, various locations, and be able to make a means of having my photos be published in real time is very important to me. So by able to utilize like my social media following and be able to utilize this, I can set up shop virtually wherever I want. As you can see, this is a photo we took the other day in news business. There was a fire truck that was being reported to a structural fire that took place. But we're going to go ahead and jump into my library, and we're going to really test to see if this is something I can use for editing photos. So I'm going to go into all photos here. And I'm just going to go ahead and pull down something I like to bring up a lot of times is EAA, which is an air enthusiast show in central Wisconsin. Actually, it's in eastern Wisconsin. So if you guys have been to it, you guys will recognize some of it. If you haven't, I encourage you to do so. But here's a filter of all those photos. Let's just take a minute and look at a couple of these here, just for quality's sake. Now, this here is some firework photos. Now, I can go ahead, I can click on these and bring these in. And this is pretty impressive from the quality standpoint. And again, I can make my screen a little bigger if I wanted to. So I really wanted to get in and see this photo and be immersed in it and change any color quality. I could easily do that. Now, one thing I have noticed as I'm talking to you, one of the cons, I guess, is the screen has a slight shake to it. And I think that is simply because I'm moving my cheekbones and that's causing the glasses, or in this case, the Vision Pro headset, to kind of shake. But when I don't talk, it's perfectly sharp. The other thing I want to point out is when I'm looking over to my left here, you can see all photos is in focus. But if you were to scan to the right, you would see that this over here has a soft focus to it. Our eyes will focus on things that are in our view and kind of make everything else soft. But as I pan to the right, you'll see now these words are all in focus and this over here is a little soft. Probably from someone watching this video, it's annoying because your focal point is not the same as my focal point with my eyes. But when I'm in this virtual space, I like it because it's able to give me focus on what it is I'm choosing to do. So let's go ahead and let's choose a photo here that we can edit in real time and just take a peek at it. I will be honest, a lot of my favorite photos I've already edited. But I'm sure we can find a photo here that'll be fun to edit that we haven't done so far. And maybe one of these war boards is pretty cool. This photo here is really neat. Okay, let's dial into this one. Okay, so I wish I knew what this was. I think it's a Mustang. If you guys know, hit the comments up. Let me know. But we're going to go into development mode. And the first thing we're going to do is just make some adjustments. So I'm going to go quiet for a minute and go through my photo editing process. I'll probably speed through this a little bit. But that way you can see how it is for me to go ahead and edit in real time. All right, so right there is my photo. You can see the before and you can see the after. I do like that. Now I'm going to go ahead and make a duplicate of that. And just see what that would look like in black and white. Well, I do really like that. So now in this case here, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to export. And I'm going to call this EAA Warbird. And I'm going to export it. And just for the sake of why that's exporting, I'm just going to go to full window here and enter full screen. And then just kind of sit back. And this gives me a chance to see what it really looks like in full screen. That is absolutely amazing. So next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead here. Here is my photo. I'm going to export that. Pull that up. You can see there's the photo as it's exported. Just think that is so cool. And we are going to go ahead and share that to my photo library. Recent imports here. And we are just going to add that to photography. And then go into photography. And there's our photo. Now that's from July 26th this last year. Now we're gonna come over here where my photos were. Now, keep in mind, there's no way to really tether the connection at this point, so everything has to work through wireless. Now, I could just go right into Safari here and upload my photos, but for this case scenario, I want to be able to go into my photo library here, and we're going to go into search, and we're going to go up to here, and we're just going to type in Warbirds. And hit search. And just see if it's there yet. Now, it might not have populated it. That's the only disadvantage. And you can see there's one of the photos from yesterday that I took right there, which you can see is a photo we published right here. So very cool. You can kind of see that real time. Now, if I wanted to go ahead and add that photo again, I could go right up to here where it says create a post. So we're going to do that. Hit post, and I'm going to post from my photo library. And in this case here, we're going to go right to photography, and there's that photo. Hit add, and now what it's doing is it's downloading that photo onto my device and it's placing it right there. So that is a good example how you can use your virtual workspace to really just kind of pull things together. Now if I want to create an email and send it to somebody, I could do that here, and I could go ahead and type a message. I can get into the subject line. I can come down here. I can add a photo. And the same thing here. I could go into all photos, pull in my pull that there, hit use. And now that photo is there. And you can see the size is quite big. We're going to change that a little bit, make it a large size. That brings it down a little bit. We could even go to a small. And this way we could send that photo to somebody here. We could just type in war. Bird, and then put an address and be able to send that. So does this work for me? It is actually pretty intuitive. I think if I'm in a space where I have limited monitors, or I'm in a space where I don't have a lot of depth to work with, and I want to be able to have a large canvas to be able to edit my photos, even be able to review them and publish things and have a sense of privacy sometimes, I really think this is really awesome. And it is something that I've been able to do. Yesterday, I spent about 4 hours with a headset on, and it really didn't bother me at all. Actually, when I took off the Vision Pro headset and started to work on my laptop, I really did recognize that I was limited on the space of my small laptop versus here. Now, obviously you see the transparency and things of that nature, but overall quality is quite impressive. Now, as you're watching this video, keep in mind I'm recording this from the headset itself. So what you see is a fraction of the resolution of what I'm seeing. So you need to get yourself to an Apple store and just see it for yourself. If this is something though that you think would benefit you, definitely check it out. It's really awesome for creating a large workspace while you are on the go. Guys, if you guys have some questions, go ahead and let me hit the comments. And if you learned something from this video, by all means, hit the like button. But this is a look at how you can use the Vision Pro headset. So we'll keep diving into this, but ultimately, I have to say, when I look at this device and I think about the capabilities and having a virtual space, I mean, if I'm able to use this and it's able to get me better productivity out of my day, it gives me a better quality output that I'm able to share across my work environment, it's a good investment. Now, would I go out and pay $3,500 if I wasn't intrigued by it? Probably not. But at the end of the day, I still think this is something that as technology evolves and things improve, this is generation one, and as we see more generations that come of this, it's definitely gonna be something that we're going to see change our lives. Spatial computing is what Apple's calling it, not calling it virtual headset, but now you can understand why. Am I gonna keep it?
I think so. As I can do more and more of this, I think I'll be happy to continue to share with you guys my experiences with it. If you like this and you learned a little bit and you're intrigued by it, go ahead and subscribe to my channel. Like the post so others can see. If you got a couple questions, hit the comments. By all means, I do tech reviews on different productivity apps for business and for photography and for professional, but I also bring up professional coaching for businesses and entrepreneurs, so stick around for that if you choose to. I'm Brandon Bonifer. With that being said, guys, hope to see you in the next one, Lord willing.